Deer, Riddle, Sunny, Day, Concrete Stone. Adapted by Tex Hudley. Illustrated by Miranda Hugh. Sunny, Rox, and Blair had spent the busy morning buying supplies for the salon. I felt the hair than ice cream. Great, let's see, Rox said, looking at the selections. Strawberry swirl, chocolate cheesecake, or banana berry. It's so hard to choose. Just then, Sunny heard a beautiful voice singing a song. Sunny followed the sound and spotted Johnny Ray with his guitar. I was just playing a little tune for Susan. He said, "Pat this horse, you could be a country star." Sunny exclaimed, "We should put on a show tonight." "Okay, Sunny," said Johnny Ray. "If you say I should do a show, I'll be on the show as long as it's smoke, simple, and low-key." "Absolutely," Sunny agreed. I got the salon. Sunny and her friends started preparing. What better way to spread the word about a country music concert than with some country hairstyles? Sunny suggested. Sunny, Ross, and Blair braided their hair with pieces of denim. And Doodle put on a bandana bow tie. While Johnny Ray practiced at the salon, Sunny and her friends went into town to tell everybody about the show. They met Cindy outside her bakery and discovered that she knew how to play the spoons. Sunny asked her to perform at the show and give me his backup spoons. Sunny said she also asked Peter to help. He could make music by rubbing some places from his flower shop. Sunny and her friends went to the park to check on the concert stage. They found it crowded with ballet dancers. It looks like the ballerinas are practicing for their next recital. Rox observed, "I'll ask them to be Johnny Ray's backup dancers," Sunny exclaimed. When Johnny Ray arrived at the park, Sunny voiced him into the glam band for a country star back over. "I just need my number for comb, some super stick hairspray, and glitter," said Sunny. "Glitter," Johnny Ray asked. Before he knew it, Sunny had given him a whole new look. Rox, Blair, and even Suzette barely recognized Johnny Ray. A little while later, Blair gave Sunny a status report. The lasers are set up on the stage. She said, "And the ballerinas are practicing their do-si-dos. It was time for the final sound check. For that, we need Johnny Ray," said Sunny. But he was nowhere to be found. "When would Johnny Ray leave?" Sunny asked her friends. "This will be the biggest and best show ever." That was when Sunny remembered that Johnny Ray had wanted a small, simple show. "I didn't listen," she said. "Now I have to make this right." Luckily, Doodle could speak horse. He told Sunny that Suzette knew where to find Johnny Ray. Sunny hopped in the glam band and followed the galloping horse across town. Johnny Ray was sitting sadly in his wagon by the boardwalk. "I'm sorry," Sunny told him. "I broke my number one rule. Always listen to what the customer wants." "It's okay," Johnny Ray said. "You were only trying to help. Will you give me a chance to fix this?" Sunny asked. "Okay, sure," said Johnny Ray. "First, Sunny had to get the real Johnny Ray back. I need to give you a map over in reserve," she said. After a few moments, Johnny Ray looked like himself again. Suzette winnie her approval and put his comma hat on his head. "Johnny Ray felt good. It's showtime," he declared. "Unfortunately, with so many people headed to the concert, there was a lot of traffic. It looks like we'll never get there in time," Johnny Ray said sadly. "Never say never," Sunny exclaimed. She and Johnny Ray jumped onto Suzette and galloped between the cars. Susan reached the park just in time, and Johnny Ray up on stage with his guitar. "This first song is for my good friend Sunny," he announced. Sunny smiled as Johnny Ray started to sing. The crowd went wild. It was a small, simple, and low-key show, and it was really, really fun. Ba-dang!
Thanks for watching. Stall that like button and subscribe, and I'll see you later. Goodbye.